Hi all, and I bid you a very warm welcome. Now, in this video, we will get to the Bent Pyramid, but these are some photos I took on the morning prior to arriving at the Bent Pyramid. In Heliopolis, beside the Nile, you have this sign, which is a modern sign. I don't think the park is there anymore, but Luna Park was there between 1911 and 1915, where in 1915 it was taken over by the Australian and New Zealand Armed Forces and turned into a hospital. Now, I've talked about other lunar parks and about occult significances, and certainly within this sign, I would suggest that it is suggestive of an etheric space with the etheric checkered or tessellated floor. And indeed, Charles Leadbetter writes about this aspect. On this morning, I also took photographs of the guardian-type lions with the pillars of Jachin and Boaz at the Khazar El Nil Bridge in Cairo also. Okay, the journey from Cairo to the Bent Pyramid in Dahshur is about 40 kilometers, and this is footage from the journey there on the highway. We now approach the Bent Pyramid. There is a lot that can be said about the Bent Pyramid, from the casing stones, which are possibly moulded, to its date being about 4,600 years old, it's said to be, around that time, around that age. The height, it's a big pyramid, huge pyramid. You can see the person right up in the background here at the corner of the pyramid, so this gives a bit of scale as we look at it. And the height is said to be around or just shy of 105 meters, just shy of about 344 feet. In this video, we'll have a closer look at the casing stones in particular and other aspects. These are the casing stones to the Bent Pyramid. And you can see, if you go right up to it, that it's just really flat, the bottom of it. It's pretty cool to be able to kind of see them and have this view with the casing stones. You don't get that at the Great Pyramid. Up here you can see, we can just see the top of it right now, but you can see a bit of piping coming out. So just in central shot there, there's a pipe coming out. So we just looked at the western face of the Bent Pyramid, and that pipe was at the western entrance to the inner chambers. We will now position to the satellite pyramid as per this illustration, which is situated to the south of the Bent Pyramid. This is the Bent Pyramid, and you can see the bent nature up there and some of the casing stones. This is a small pyramid right beside it, and you can see the line, the working line along here with in this case it's heavily eroded, but you have the casing stones at the bottom with this straight line marked out at the bottom. So that's the Bent Pyramid up this way. And just looking around here, yeah, there's like this opening into this smaller pyramid beside the Bent Pyramid. Just with the casing stones along here, just for detail, the markings in here, you see these on the other pyramids as well. And also, just this, even this little block remains in here on the casing stone. That's a pretty sort of full on in a way. Coming along here, you can see the little workings within along the edge, the bottom edge of these casing stones. So this is the Bent Pyramid up here, and then across this way you can see the base with the lines going through, and then up towards this direction of this smaller pyramid here, that's you see the two lines here. You also see other sort of divots in here, working divots along. Now the cornerstone here has been messed with somebody, but beyond that, heading this way again, you can see the some of the markings in here with the stones also. So some of the working within what is a, you know, pretty spent pyramid. In the earth there are these kind of ribs, depressions in the earth, no doubt old foundations, very old. This pyramid here is largely eroded away, so we're not going to get a close-up of that, but nonetheless. So here's another shot of the bent pyramid right here. We just looked at some of the foundations for this pyramid over here. We've got the bent pyramid and we have the red pyramid. We will now position to the eastern wall of the bent pyramid, and specifically to start off with the eastern chapel as per this illustration. Some adobe brick mud foundations here, but large stones and a lintel and sort of a configuration under here. Now here are some casing stones that go from here, and it actually looks like they are part of the larger pyramid, which is up here. So for whatever reason, these lower casing stones do seem to have remained. Just another, we're at the corner of the bent pyramid here, and it goes up like so. Now, just for interest, putting the camera sort of down to the level of the casing stones and getting an idea for how flat this thing really is when you look up it. Part of the equation was that a guard or police officer shadowed us around the pyramid. So by the pyramid here, there are little ants, a pretty big ant nest under this rock. Coming up, the casing stones here are... Okay, so that's the pyramid in the background that is hugely dilapidated. Now this one here though, the casing stones are awesome here. The cut, you can see the form of them, and also this is a great opportunity from the angle here. There's a few divots and stuff just over here. I can show a few photographs of that, but coming up this way you get a chance here to kind of see how kind of flat the side is going through. It's very impressive. You can see areas where the stone has eroded, like there and then up here, and then looking at the erosion, because in some places it looks chipped off, but here you can see the erosion of the stones. It's really remarkable. So just having a little look through the cavities in these stones, and you can see here the casing, the outer casing is there, and the inside has eroded away. So as pointed out here, the erosion, you can see the redness coming down the rock face, and the redness here. Now, just to point out, with these rocks here, you can see some of that similar redness within there, but just something to note on this pyramid, curiosity. So that's the parking spot in the background, and they're doing work around here. We're up on a platform here, and this is the, so there's that pyramid in the background. The red pyramid is right there, and so this is the side of the bent pyramid, and there's a door up here, doorway going in, but there is currently no access, and just more of the casing stones along here. Just to point out with the rocks on here, that with this doorway here, and maybe it assisted them to find the doorway, is that this rock here is quite large. It's acting as a lintel on the doorway, so it's almost a trilithon type doorway, but the further rocks along here are generally smaller. So that would have given a bit of an indication perhaps as to an entryway into this pyramid. Now it's reasonably high up, so if all the casing stones were there, it would be pretty hard to get up to this point. So the lintel is here, just further, you can see some of the detail with the stonework here also. Extraordinary use of different sizes and shapes of stone on the sides of these pyramids even. The bent pyramid, and the on the corner here you have this scaffolding up here, and it's really impressive. So I hope you've enjoyed looking at some of the detail around the bent pyramid in Dahshur, Egypt. In Dahshur also there is the red pyramid, of which we will actually go inside, so that will be in part 2. See you there.